TFNN. Headline news update.
Anybody in the den? Yikes. What the heck happened? I think we're back. I'm just going to do the 2 p.m. update. Hopefully you can hear me. If not, I'm just talking to myself. So, folks, welcome. This is Steve Rhodes coming to you live from the shores of sunny Delray Beach, Florida. And this is your 2 p.m. update. Currently, we got the all the U.S. indices are trading higher. The Dow's up 250. The S&P's up 41. NASDAQ 157. Russell 63. That's nearly 3% to the upside. The semis are up 65 points, 2%. Trend is up 1.5% or 211 points out there. Let's just go take a look at our indice charts out there. Give me a moment as we switch screens, and we'll begin by taking a look at the Dow in the upper left-hand corner. Actually, as you take a look at today's bar configuration, in fact, let your eyes rotate or move over to the upper right-hand corner to the Russell 2000. What each of these bars, these are wide-ranging bars, what each of these bars look like is that we are going to finish at the high of the day. When you have these wide-ranging bars, odds favor, and this is where you open. You don't even have a bottom wick, and typically you're just simply going to continue to move higher through the entire trading session, and that is what it looks like to me. So for those of you on a Friday at 2 o'clock that are trying to time some type of short trade, I'm saying don't do it. But go back and study these wide-ranging bars, and it's not that they can't back off a bit, but odds favor that we close at the highs, especially on a Friday, and especially for those folks that were trying to take the short trade out there because their sphincter muscles are going to get mighty tight. Now, as we take a look at the Dow in the upper left-hand corner, if it closes above its green oscillator and change line, that suggests that it makes a run for its all-time high. If we take a look at the S&P 500, it is at its all-time high, and prices trade above that green line says it wants to continue to move higher. We do have wave number 7 that is present inside the NDX 100, but you need a lower high in order to confirm that pattern. Price above its green oscillator and change line says it wants to move higher. In the case of the Russell 2000, just a gigantic move that we've seen here this week. Price could be heading all the way back into the 2340 type level. The semis, they form that nice TD 9 count bottom, bar number 5, taking out resistance of 3409, and that says that this wants to continue to move higher. The transports are headed to the 15,000 level, their prior swing point. Spot volatility says a one-day rate of change below minus 10%, it's minus 13.32. That says this is an initiation move to higher price for the S&P 500 and the XAU. It's on a buy. It formed that nice Rhodes Momentum Indicator bottom. It wants to continue to move higher. Folks, stay tuned. The Power Trading Hour is up next with your host, David White. And have a fantastic Friday. I'll see you on Magnificent Monday. Have a great day.
The reality